Hi guys, so I told you that I would put up a video of my hospital bag. I'm 34 weeks today, but I did a little bit early. I've had it kind of in the trunk of my car for a week or so because with twins, they could come at any time and I want to be prepared. I mean, I could go to any doctor visit or any one of those NST testing days and they could say, okay, today's the day. So I just want to be prepared. So I'll show you like everything that I have in the bag. I made a list of what mommy needs, what daddy needs, what the babies need, and then miscellaneous. So let me kind of show you what the bag looks like that I'm bringing, and then I'll show you every little thing. So here's the bag. It's kind of big, and I was worried that it was too big, but I want to be able to fit my laptop in there. And so I will be able to with that, just because I'm kind of funny about leaving the room and then having my laptop in there, and I want to just kind of have it at the bottom and everything. So, first things first, I made a list, so I might continue looking at my laptop over here to make sure that I tell you everything. But first off, I'm not bringing any kind of nightgown or pajamas or anything like that. I'm not like a nightgown person. I'm more of like a shorts and t-shirt type person, and I'm going to be having a C-section, so I don't think I'll be wearing shorts or wanting to. Those first few days. So I'm just going to stick with the hospital nightgowns. Plus, I think it'll be easier because I'm going to try to be nursing the girls. And so the hospital nightgowns, I think, just make it a little bit easier. So I'm just sticking with that. I am bringing some comfy gray shorts for, just in case I do feel like I want to wear shorts, and not like have my butt hanging out. So that's one thing. And then the other thing is, of course, the nursing bra. I'm only bringing one, and I've only bought one so far because my bras are really expensive. I have to go to a specialty store, and I want to make sure that I'm actually able to breastfeed before I go outlandish and buy a whole bunch of stuff. I have these cheapo slippers, very cheap. They're like crappy, and the reason for that is I work in a hospital, and ladies, hospitals are dirty. The floors, there's a lot of people that come in and out. There's a lot of fluids and stuff like that. And so I'm not bringing these home when I leave the hospital. These are going like right in the trash because I do not want to bring in what is in the hospital into my home. Ugh. And when I'm at work, I always take off my shoes outside. I never bring my shoes inside because it's gross. Okay, another thing that I'm bringing is just regular flip-flops. Like I said, I'm funny about my feet, and I'll be wearing those in the shower because, I just don't want my feet on, like, the shower floor. And then the bag I put them in is just going to be a bag for dirty clothes or anything that needs to come home that I don't want mixed up with everything else. Another thing is I'm bringing just some socks, just some, like, regular white socks and then, like, some comfy socks. Just depends on kind of what I'm feeling like. Because it might be cold. When my feet are cold, I'm cold. And then I'm grumpy. So, yeah. And then I just have some like regular underwear just for my coming home. Because the hospital provides these throwaway ones, which everybody raves about. And I'm just going to wear what the hospital has. It's like you're paying for it. You might as well use it. And then I just have just a comfy, maternity top to wear home. And then just some comfy pants. I know I'm just going to want to really just not have a whole lot like on my belly, and so these are actually the most comfortable that I have. Okay, and then I still have to put in my contacts and my my glasses and my re-wetting like drops and stuff, and then I still need to put in my hair dryer, and so that's not in there yet because that's kind of like last minute things. Now for my hubby, I'm going to be packing some pajama bottoms for him, some of his like comfy like workout shorts, because seriously, ladies, you just want your husband to be comfortable as well as you, because those rooms are not comfortable, the beds are not comfortable, so you really, really just need to like bring comfy stuff. So I packed him some socks, some underwear, like some undershirts, and then just some like regular t-shirts, not a whole lot, just a couple, just because it's like he can probably come home to take a shower, but I don't know if he'll be able to because I'm gonna have two babies and I don't know if I want to be left alone. So we'll see. So that's what I'm packing for Daddy. Not a whole lot. I'm also packing him some, let me see, I have it over here. I'm packing him some, like, granola bars and stuff like that, because there's going to be times that I'm not going to be allowed to eat, you know, before surgery, and then I won't be able to eat right after surgery, and I don't want him leaving me and going down to the vending machines and stuff, so I want him to be able to have something to kind of munch on. He thinks I'm crazy, but tell me, trust me, he's gonna really appreciate bringing that. Okay, so for the babies, let me go down on my list. I don't leave anything out. So the babies, oh, you know what? I left out my toiletries. So I'm bringing this big thing of toiletries, and I'm just bringing like a few pads because, you know, I know the hospital pads are sufficient, but sometimes they're like really big and bulky, so if I'm not bleeding like a whole lot, I want to use like my own. And then I'm bringing just a couple of nursing pads and some of the lanolin cream, because I know the lanolin sometimes is a prescription in the hospital, and I don't want to have to wait for the doctor to fill that prescription. It's like, I've got it, I can use it in case I start to hurt. And the nursing pads, you don't need a whole lot, because more than likely you're not going to be in the hospital long enough to have your whole milk supply come in anyways. But because I'm having a C-section, I might be there for 4 days, and your milk can come in as early as 3 days. So I just want to be a little bit prepared. I like my gum, so I have my gum. I have my chapstick. I'm a chapstick person. And then I have my toothpaste and my mouthwash and all that. I have two toothbrushes, one for me, one for my husband. I have my fluff. And this one also, I bought just a cheap little one because I'm just going to throw it away when I'm there because I'm not bringing that home. And then in this baggie is just going to be like my shampoo, my conditioner, my body wash, my razor. I got a razor for the hubby too, just in case he doesn't want to look all grimy, but honestly, we're probably not even going to care. And then I have some of my eye solution for my contacts. And some lotion. And, oops, the lid came off. Some deodorant for me and for the hubby. That's very important. Don't you just love these little travel size? I went to Target and just bought all travel size. So much fun. And then shaving cream for the hubby. And then the last thing in here is my brush. Now, I bought this new brush, just a small one, and then I have, like, a whole bunch of hair clippies and stuff and hair ties hooked to it just in case, because I don't know what I'm going to want, how I'm going to want to wear my hair and all of that. And then I'm also going to bring a little bit of makeup. I'm not a big makeup person, as you guys have probably seen, but I definitely don't want to look crappy in my pictures. So, yeah, I'm just going to bring like a little bit just in case. It just depends on how I'm feeling. I have no idea after surgery how I'm going to be feeling about all of that. So